Shloma, has the time come to implement this instrument of last resort? Because General Bakshi is worried about the likes of Arundhati Roy turning in over there and really making life difficult for the Indian Army. The Naxals are clearly not bothered about our human rights. They're killing 100 people every month. The time has come for India to act. Do you think so?
Rahul, I cannot say it more strongly that this is the biggest recipe for disaster. The general is saying this, you know, the DGP, the DG of BSF, Mr. E.N. Ram Mohan, who was deputed by the Home Ministry to look into the CRPF massacre in Dantewada, very, very strongly saying that calling in the army is a recipe for civil war, it's a recipe for disaster, and he's saying we have to address root causes. You know, General Bakshi's assumption that the likes of Arundhati Roy will make it difficult for the army by alleging rape and by alleging killings is exactly the mindset that will bring this situation into an even more escalated violence, you know, because the fact is that right now the need of the hour is to address the issues of justice. Forget about bringing in the army, which really is like declaring that your own people are alien to you. It will bring us into a Pakistan-like situation. But much more than that, we have, you know, you mentioned that the army fought the Naxals in Naxalbari in 71. You've had four movements of the Naxal movement after that. Why? Because governments in succession have not addressed root causes. This is not an identity war. This is not an identity war. And do you know that when we say that there's no options, that the constitution has dictated under the fifth schedule that the center can issue directives on governance in tribal areas. In 60 years, no central government has ever issued a single directive.
You're talking about the need to administer justice. I want to bring in Professor Sujato Bhadra, who's got very strong views on this. Professor Bhadra, a lot of people would say the need to administer justice sounds nice in a television studio, but over here the Naxals are running large and they're really administering Taliban-like justice. They're killing people by the dozens every week. We can't talk about human rights in a situation where the Naxals are getting more and more savvy when it comes to military operations. Their operations are getting more and more lethal. Do you think it's time to bring the army out of the barracks into the jungle, sir?
I'm opposing to use of army or paramilitary forces even in tackling with Naxalism. Even the Prime Minister in the last press conference has said that India and the government is committed to human rights. Once you government has declared that government is committed to human rights, government cannot use army against its own people.
So what about the commitment of Naxals to human rights? Do they have no commitment? You're asking the Indian state to be so compassionate. What happens to these terrorists who are killing people week in, week out, sir?
It's a very... 1 minute. Yes, I'm answering. Government is the legal power and legitimate power to uphold human rights. And the Naxalites, if violate the human rights, the law are there to punish them. But you cannot use army against the people with whom the Naxal having a social base. Once you attack the Naxalite, means you are attacking social base of the entire area. So population will be under attack. And the government is acting in favor of the corporate house to allow them to loot our resources. The entire war against Maoism is nothing but grabbing of the natural resources that our motherland is possessing, our people is possessing, our co-citizens are possessing. It is amply clear the government now enacting in favor of the corporate to plunder our resources. And
General
one
Bakshi
section
wants
of media
to respond to what you're saying.
The myth,
General
the
Bakshi wants to respond to what you're saying. General Bakshi.
I would just like to state that when a house is on fire, you do not start asking a string of questions as to who lit the fire, why was it lit, when was it lit, who is to blame. I am afraid the first thing that you have to do is to put that fire out.
That's an excellent analogy.
Madam, can I, madam, with your kind permission? It's all very well to say that it is a question of governance. I'm afraid what you haven't done for the last 60 years, quite certainly you are paying the price for it today. The point at issue is, now that 76 CRPF men are being killed, 142 innocent civilians are being blown up in trains, I'm afraid it is, do you expect a tehsildar or a block development officer to go to his constituency and carry out development? The basic problem is the lack of infrastructural penetration. Please see the issue in a larger historical light.
That's an excellent point you make. And I want to get General Malik. General Malik to respond to this. Just a moment, Shoma. I want to get General Malik to respond to this. General Malik, General Bakshi says the house is on fire and we're looking at why there is no fire tender around. We need to get together and put the fire out, sir.
I know that. But you see, even in trying to do that, we know the kind of mess that people are making today, in both at policy level as well as on the implementation level. There is no coordination between the state and the center. You are not sending the right kind of leaders to the CRPF, etc. You are not even training them. You are not equipping them. And what about these problems?